Why, hello! Welcome on in, Pat and AJ, post-show video.
Wow, there goes the bell.
We're here on the last day of January.
Thank God, it's been the longest January ever.
It's a long January.
Oh, thank goodness February's short.
Okay, I know I'm looking forward to summer travel. Are you? It's good to get out, get about.
Yes.
We're not going to be bringing any additional guests with us, though. Yes, this is why we can't have nice things. Everyone's PO'd at Delta because Delta has tightened up their rules on companion animals. Now, if you don't know, there's different levels. You can have like an emotional support dog.
That's different than a service dog.
Yes, okay. It is. So you have like a service dog that maybe works with someone who is blind, right?
Yeah.
And they lead you through. Then you have an emotional support animal because you are not emotionally stable enough to be traveling, so you have to bring an animal with you.
Now, that sounds like me.
I do not want to take away from people who actually have these needs. I know people that suffer from crippling depression and anxiety, and getting out of the house is hard. But
when you bring a peacock to an airport, don't be surprised when they tell you you can't have it on the plane.
It's like Delta couldn't write this better, because just as they announced their new policy, which makes you provide all types of documentation, not only about your animal, but yourself, like 48 hours in advance, if you want to bring one on their flight.
I kid you not, like clockwork, somebody brought an emotional support peacock to the Newark airport over the weekend and tried to get it on the plane.
On a United flight. So now all these people are like going after Delta, and you know, some of them, rightfully so, blind folks are saying, what are we supposed to do? But Delta's going, hey, if you don't think there's a problem,
check out what happened on United. Delta's statement, it was funny, about the animals that people have tried to bring on flights. They said everything from possums to emotional support spiders.
Sugar gliders?
Anyone? Wouldn't they say that's like a flying possum? Regardless, the peacock is not the weirdest emotional support animal that has ever been brought to an airport.
Listen, I get it. Some of the emotional support doctor certifications are about as legit as like medical marijuana certifications.
Oh, you have a headache? Here you go. Go get some pot.
I mean, basically, they found someone who has a vet license and you sign off on it. Listen, for the folks who legitimately need an animal to get out of the home and to operate your life in a safe and normal way, you keep fighting a good fight. Now, for that hippie that was at the musical festival with me in Pennsylvania with a service dog.
That was not a service dog. That was the worst behaved service dog I've ever seen.
That was like barking and jumping all around?
No.
You just wanted to fly with your dog.
You can't just put the vest on him. That's not how this works.
All right, click on the button below. Subscribe to the Cars 108 YouTube channel. Yell at us about this if you want. Old playlists are over there. We'll see you tomorrow. Back
Bye.
In.
Bye.